Hey guys, this is LJZO724, and this is a review of A Stir of Echoes by Richard Matheson. Before I get into that review, as I said, since I'm finished with A Stir of Echoes, I'm going to go on to It. And as I'm reading it, I also plan on reading this. It's not really a big deal, it's just a comic book, so I should get through pretty quickly. It's Fahrenheit 451 comic book, and I just am really excited to see how it plays out in a comic book format, really. Just see how they condense it and all that. So yeah, and also, just the other day I started track practice at my school, so I'm even more pressed for time, and that therefore means I have even less time to read, if that's possible. So sorry if it takes me a while to get book reviews up, but I really just don't have that much time to read. I'll try to read when I can, just letting you know. Anyway, here's my review on Stir of Echoes by Richard Matheson. Now, this is my second book that I've ever read by Richard Matheson. My first was I Am Legend. Oh my gosh, great book, great introduction to him. Holy crap, I cannot say enough to sort of, you know, demonstrating how good it was. You gotta read it. And the movie does not do justice. The 2008, that sucks. But anyway, Stir of Echoes, my second Richard Matheson book. 223 pages, big font, generally quick read. And what it's basically about is a guy named Tom Wallace, who, him and his wife Anne, they go to sort of a neighborhood party, and once there, there's this guy named Phil, and he offers to hypnotize someone, and people are very skeptical, and they don't want to volunteer themselves, but Tom Wallace is like, what could go wrong? Well, he finds out what can go wrong, because once hypnotized, and once he's, you know, brought back from being hypnotized, he realizes he's basically a medium. He's the power to read other people's minds, read their emotions, and even at night, he can see this ghost of a black-haired woman wearing a dress. You can see this ghost in his living room. That is scary. And you find out later as to what the ghost is all about. I don't want to spoil it. But all I'll say is, yeah, Tom Wallace becomes a medium. And his relationship with his wife, Anne, becomes very strained. Because his wife keeps on telling him, go see this doctor. He will help fix you. Because obviously you aren't mentally stable. And emotionally stable. But Tom Wallace keeps on refusing. He says, it's fine. It's a gift, I'll use it. It's not that bad. And it does escalate more and more. And also, it does get him into some... This psychic ability does get him into some confrontations with his neighbors. For instance, there's this one neighbor, I forget what her name is. Yeah, sorry, I totally forget all of a sudden what her name is. But she's this one neighbor, and seeing as Tom can read her mind, he finds out this neighbor, this female, actually has a crush on Tom. And he gets all these, like, visions from her full of lust, all these signals, and he's sort of taken aback. He doesn't know what to think. So he sort of acts very awkward around here. Her, tries to avoid her. Just even one moment, I don't want to spoil it. All I'll say is, involves Tom and Anne's son, Richard, the little kid. It involves Richard and his babysitter while Tom and Anne are going out on a date. Yeah, it's a weird part. All in all, yeah, this is a great, great suspenseful book. And as I said, yeah, this is my second Richard Matheson book. Basically, when I read I Am Legend, that set the bar high under Richard Matheson's name in my mind. I was like, holy crap, this Richard Matheson author, he's awesome. So I read this going in with high hopes on his writing, and yeah, he fulfilled those expectations with A Stir of Echoes. I'm not even kidding. This book, I'm going to have to give it a 4 out of 5. It's just, it's not the best, but it's just a great suspenseful psychic ability story. It basically answers the question, what would happen if an ordinary person were to suddenly realize they had psychic abilities and they were a medium? You get the answer from this book, and it's very interesting. It just shows, like, how you can change people's lives and how your life can completely change with those abilities. There's one part where he foresees a train accident where a train derails. He has this vision in the middle of the night. He writes down a pad of paper. The next day, it actually happens, and they announce it on the radio. It's too late to alert anybody, but he's surprised as hell about that. So yeah, great, great suspenseful book. I'm really excited to read some more of Richard Matheson's books, such as Madhouse. Or was it Hell House? Madhouse? Hell House? Something like that. And then there's also, Richard Matheson actually wrote the story, what is it? Oh, crap. It is... Wow, it doesn't have it in my book. Oh, and it was Hell House, but it doesn't have the title of this one story in my book. It's like 20,000 feet in the air or something like that. But it's what inspired the Twilight Zone episode about that, like, gremlin only this one guy can see, and the gremlin's, like, tearing up the plane turbines and such on the wing of the plane. He's, like, going insane, saying, oh my gosh, we're gonna crash, and the plane does crash. So I'm excited to see Richard Matheson's written version of that story. Also, Richard Matheson actually wrote The Incredible Shrinking Man, which I've heard about that story for a while. I guess that could be a classic. I'm surprised he wrote that. And then, yeah, I Am Legend. That's about it of his books that I've ever heard of. I'll be sure to read his other books as well. But all in all, Richard Matheson, you really have fulfilled my expectations. I mean, I haven't found really any faults with your books. They're just a great horror reads. And from what I've read so far, your books really aren't that long either. So, great, just quick reads. So, yeah, four out of five, and thank you.